Hello folks, so we are at this place called Vilondi Teertham. It is very close to Pamban and it's a little away from Rameshwaram's main town. Vil translates to bow and arrow, Teertham translates to a water body.
It is said that when the Vanara army was coming back victorious after the war with Ravana's army, they felt thirsty and they asked Rama for saying that feeling thirsty, how do we quench our thirst? So apparently Rama threw an arrow right into the sea, and that's that point after which water came out and the team basically quenched their thirst. So you're dipping the bow into seawater, and that's where this water body or Teertham was made. Vilondi Teertham basically translates as Vil as bow and arrow, Teertham as a water body. Let's go have a look at what this is and how it looks like. I know it's been now close to, Ramayana was said to have happened in the Treta Yuga, which must have been roughly 4000 BC and about 2000 years after that, so 6000 years back. So let's see how it's maintained.
Look here.
Urban bores of, how water is not there. So I think I'm able to see water 15 feet below. The fact that there isn't enough water around, water tables have dried up. But that's the place, that's the monument that we are here to see. And it's great to find the connect between geography and history here at this place called the Vilondi Teertham.
Can I do that?
Hirma, they are doing it, no?
Fine, after this.
Felt he had committed a sin. So to atone for it, he basically paid obeisance to the Shivalinga. And while he paid obeisance to the Shivalinga, this spot became famous. So this is what the whole place is about. Since Lakshman has paid obeisance to the Shivalinga, a whole center has come up here. It's called the Lakshmana Teertha. A very nice and beautiful pond that we see here. But we are a little short on time. We still have about a couple of more places to visit before the sun decides to call it a day. And in the tropics, the sun actually sets a little earlier. So I'm just going to quickly gaze around and then see what's the next spot today. So we're now, quite a long day today. So we're now outside the Panchamukha Anjaneya temple. It seems there are rocks here that float. And I'm trying to connect that to that specific chapter in Ramayana where Ram and Hanuman go build that bridge. So let's go inside and see what this looks like.
So hi everyone, I'm outside the memorial for Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, one of India's most loved and most famous scientists, and of course the former president of India, and a source of inspiration for so many people. Unfortunately, they don't allow mobiles inside. No mobiles and no photography allowed. So this is all I can get to. I'm going to go inside and take a look at what's there inside.